Item C, to allow representation regarding planning application within the civil parish of Anston to be considered later in the meeting. Allow one question per lecture of the civil parish of Anston on a topic for which the parish council has a responsibility or which affects the parish.
These ladies would like to say something, I believe.
My name's Sue Simcox and I live in the bungalow of Hoxton House. I wanted to ask about the maintenance of the trees on the ground adjacent to my property and to my neighbour Mrs Fowler's property. You will be aware that we have both suffered damage to our properties. My neighbour had a tree fall and hit her shed, causing significant damage. I had a tree fall on the day before New Year's Eve, causing significant damage to my roof. And I do actually want to say to Mr. John Ireland, I've never met him before, but I just want to say thank you so much for your prompt action, and you got somebody out to us within one hour. To fix it. My question is, what is the parish council going to do to ensure that those trees are kept in good order? Because I understand that some of the trees are hollow, they're rotten, and although they've been topped, there may well be, for me, an issue of safety. My anxiety is not just for myself, it's for any child that's playing on that playing field, and I did put in my letter to the parish and to Robin Borough Council, but my concern was that this was a life and limb situation, and I think we're very fortunate that it's property that's been damaged and not a child's life that's been endangered. I just want to add a rider to that as well. I was really upset that the parish council wrote to me and invited me to use my own insurance put right the damage that's been caused by the trees, despite knowing that we have made representations previously about the state of the trees on the parish land.
Anybody else?
Could I add something to that? Yeah.
Yeah, please.
It's Ben Bentley. I'd like to give you some reassurances, actually, and some actions which I've been taking on behalf of residents who border onto Anston Plantation, and I've been dealing with that in some depth under item E in my co-option address to you. So there might be some good news coming.
Sandra?
Yeah.
What is your question?
It's from different, you know, isn't it?
Yeah.
The skate park, can we not give some help to Miles? I sit in hairdressers and I'm listening to ladies going mad about into school break, taking the children, having to come away because this skate park is in such a state. I mean, I just sat there and I never said a word. I thought, oh, my you could fill this place 10 times over with people who was absolutely appalled at the state of that skate park. I'm having to run my grandkids to Kibbing or to Maltby, and we should have a skate park here. Can you not give Miles some help?
Can I come in there, please?
Yeah, just a moment, please.
I'd love
to make
as well. Is this something that we could do?
No.
I mean, 2 years ago, we've got kids all in here. They're at our house last week, wanting to know, you promised us earth. We were having this skate park. What's happening? I can't go all the miles.
Can you, is that your question, Sandra? What's happening there?
Yeah, he needs some help to get this thing moving.
Right, thank you. Any others?
Can I just come in at that, please?
Yeah, well, is it a question about that? Or?
Yeah, well, it can be.
Well, if you make it one.
Well, I will do.
Please.
Yes. When Miles Manship first came
to this council meeting on his very first attendance here. He sat here next to me, Christine and Sandra, and he said quite clearly that he got a skate park up at Woodsetts and he would do this, and he'd have it done in a year. Now, Miles, I've made inquiries about this and you're getting a skate park up at Woodsetts, and it doesn't seem to be quite the truth. And where are you now? How many years have you been coming? And you said that you would have it all done and up and running in a year. So why not?
Okay, the question is, why hasn't he?
Why hasn't he fulfilled what he said?
Can we just go back to question one then, from Mrs. Simcox? Does anybody want to? John, I know you took the phone call, didn't you, on that?
No, I think as far as I was concerned, she phoned me up. It was absolutely silent down the rain, and I got in touch with the clerk, who got to Kevin Cavanagh, and Kevin, what did he say, Kevin, to come, and Kevin Pearson to come, and they put it right. I mean, the lady was sitting in the house, the rain coming through the roof, what could you do? And I was very satisfied with it. She said she was satisfied with the service she got, and I'm satisfied that it provided. I don't answer for anything else. I don't have any camera on the day.
I'm going to say something. This off.
Can I just say that I've got hearing, I wear hearing aids, I've got a hearing complaint.
I'm sorry.
And so
can you hear me?
I'll speak up. Sorry. Have you got teeth on you? You got teeth on you?
No.
Because we've got a hearing lump in, so.
I'm going to say something now that you probably don't want to hear, it's quite important.
Can you speak into it, please?
Yeah. I don't think it's on.
Can you get it on?
I'll try and shout. Can you hear me now?
I can.
Right. I would say something that's probably not very popular. I haven't seen the letter you've had about the insurance, but this is my opinion. In the first instance, you should have actually gone to your insurance company to make a claim against the council. Although, as I say, I know the look at your face is not popular. That's what should have happened. I personally disagree with what happened on the night because I don't think we followed certain procedures we have done. Although, that will sort itself out in the future. Can I suggest that you speak to your insurers if you haven't? Because you may be able to make some form of claim against the council's insurance, which may sort everything out in the long term.
Why would I need to go through my insurance company and then have a penalty against my person, and it costs me money?
That's just the way things
happen.
I have
a hole in the roof and a crying baby.
Yeah.
And as far as I'm concerned, Mr. Island was nothing but a gentleman, and the chap Kevin that came out was wonderful. It was a temporary repair, but where does that leave me? It was resolved within an hour, and I think
it's reasonable. I said I wouldn't be popular in what I've said. I think what should have happened, and I don't think the council followed the correct procedure. Whether I'm right or wrong is a different matter. What should have happened is they should have told you to contact your insurer immediately. Your insurer should have instructed you to get somebody to do the job immediately, and then put a claim against the council, which. Things work slightly different, but that's all I'm going to say at this stage.
It's not a discussion, it's a question and answer. Ron, do you want to?
I just say on behalf of all the council thinkers, I want to say thank you to John and to the two Kevins for being just so prompt in their action.
Could you pass
without, please? Can I just make a comment? The question actually was, what are we going to aim to ensure about the remaining trees? That was actually the question that was asked, not really the insurance. What we had a survey last year. Not last year. Well, what we'll do, we'll undertake another survey. Should be easy as well. That'll have to go on the agenda to be discussed. But we will make sure that the sort of monitored from that point of view. I'm going to bring Christine in and then Drew. Well, I don't know, because you've had one.
I've had that, Lisa.
Go on, Chris.
Is it me?
Yeah.
Yes. Is it possible to know the exact procedure in a case like this regarding insurance companies? Because I know that they have set procedures.
We're actually asking more questions than the one that the lady...
I know, but it needs clearing up, Clive. This lady's been waiting for weeks.
For what?
Well, to come here for a start. And to get some satisfaction in the queries she has.
Can we have a parish council meeting? Can I just bring Drew in?
I was just going to... Is it working? Yeah. So that seems... can't hear it from here for some reason. I was just going to pick up on the second point. I think it's important...
Can't hear you, Drew.
Is it not working?
Okay. That's it.
That's better. We are in the process of investigating the status of the land and the lease associated with the programme. So I think we just second everybody else in saying that we will undertake to make sure that the trees are safe in the future.
Can I ask the real chair, can I ask the clerk if we actually paid for this work to be done?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we paid for it.
We paid for it.
We're the other one, we paid for it, tell you now.
Paid for what? You mean the trees or the roof?
For sending out our contractors.
Yeah, because we had to do it as an emergency.
Yes.
That's because somebody was. Well, because that's not the emergency.
The job well done.
Sorry, Kevin. Anybody? Any other councillors?
I thought that's what we're here for.
Can I move on to... was this warm? Yeah, that, sorry. The question is, can Martin give us some help with the skate park?
Do you want to make a declaration of interest first?
Council meeting hasn't started yet,
Do you want to make any comment on that, Miles?
Could you use the microphone, please?
I mean, have you kept Mrs. Walden informed of where you are?
Yeah. Oh, I have a 5-foot fence, and I will show you that pack that I've put together for him.
John, can you let him have the microphone?
Because we've got like a standard, it's the same questions cropping up all the time now, so it's a big pack
put together for it.
It is a long process. It's a lot bigger than the one that I was in good sense, isn't it? And I have said throughout the meetings it's not going to be a quick process as well, haven't I?
Well, I know that.
It's been a year and a half, isn't it?
I've got money for a pack of pot and send off the frontage. I know how long it does take, but, you know...
And that's it for being with it as well.
Stuart started this off before you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unfortunately, after we've taken off. That's another story.
It was stopped from...
Okay, that's not relevant in this moment.
Right, but if you had some more help...
I would gladly welcome it, yes.
With some of these fundings, because there is an enormous amount to work.
I am actually going to be, with my next presentation, I will be bringing the pack to the council to have a look at it.
Because I know last time you spoke, you said you failed it.
Because of the one works on.
Because of the proximity of works and that.
But unfortunately...
Unfortunately, Sandra, that's the way it works. It's not for one to try. We've tried several times. You can't get it because either something in Woodsetts works at Horton, wherever. And unless you comply with their requirements, then you'll not actually be successful in the funding bit. And unfortunately, that's the way of the world. I think Miles is probably finding that now, but it's very difficult.
Evidence.
That's rather different to what you said when you came to the first meeting.
Okay, thank you. Come on, Ellen, just let him finish, please.
But, you know, if more help is given, you know, it's a wash out there with all the... It's a wash with funding for all sorts, but it takes time.
But if you did it at Woodsetts, why doesn't you know where to go?
Please,
why doesn't you know where to go for answers?
Because... Funding regimes change, the bid procedures change. I'm not sort of making any excuse, I'm just saying it's extremely difficult to get the right bid in and get the money.
Yeah, but you've got to have people working for it. Thurcroft got a grant. Tideswell, out in Derbyshire, Tideswell,
£1,000. Look, Sandra, you know.
And they're far more wealthier than what we are here.
It may well be, but it's down to the funders at the end of the day. They don't want to give us the money, they won't give it us a
funder. Well, which funders has the approach?
I have no idea. This is we stray way off subject, and this is
not relevant.
Well, we are.
No, we're not.
Because Miles is going to come back and do a presentation to where we are the next meeting. So if anybody wants to listen to him, I can turn it there.
Why did he say when he came here so many years ago that he was going to have it done within a year?
Well, it's obviously not worked out that well, has it?
Well, no, and it is. Can't he answer what else?
Sandra, you know that I went to those meetings and tried to help as much as I could.
No, you didn't.
I've not had any involvement since last year.
No, we've had any involvement. There's no meetings.
Well, but it's not down to us to know.
There's been no meetings for a long time.
It's not down to me or anybody else on this gap other than Miles
and Morgan. And the two lady friends, because as soon as they didn't get them cancelled, they went goodbye. They were, so what interest had they got in it? None.
Exactly.
No, but what I'm saying is, if other
councillors want to be involved, if Miles wants to ask people to be involved, then he can do it. But I can't make other councillors become involved in a project if they don't want to.
Yeah, but it's for the community.
I know that, but I can't make people do what they don't want to do, Sandra. I've tried, and I've not heard anything about that skateboard back for over a year. I've not been invited to any meeting or anything.
At the moment, meetings are...
It's done nothing.
Well, you know, we're filling in the forms and we've sat down to them as a group.
Mm.
It's been difficult, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So when we... it's just better to sit down.
You did all this going through on the project. You used to hold a meeting every 3 months with the skate park committee. Has all that gone by the book?
That's all gone. Why hasn't Miles picked it up then?
I don't know. That's what... Well, one more question.
But is he going to get some help?
I can't say. I mean, I don't know what you want me to tell. What you want me to tell you?
If it helps,
I
can organise for the next meeting.
It's up to people to volunteer, isn't it?
Can I volunteer?
Yeah.
We've already declared, Chair, that the parish council will back you.
We've said as much as we can do at this moment.
Just to speak, and then
as a volunteer, because the parish council.
Who wants to do it? I'm going to. This is. Kevin, I'll let you ask one last question. Sorry, it's finished. Mrs. Estrada Hayne, you've asked the question. I thought Miles had answered it already.
Hasn't.
Well, I think he has.
No, actually. He hasn't.
Because he said that he hadn't managed to get any funding. Well, he's tried his best and he can't say any more than that.
Not good enough. He said that he would have it done in a year. He also said that he had done, not the one at Woodsets. And that is not true.
Right. Okay. Fair.
So why has he come here telling lies?
I'm going to move on. We're not going down that road. Sorry.
Madam Chair,
I'm going to close a public session at that point and move on.
If I can't ask me a question, then Clive.
Well, perhaps, you know, you're out of time, Kevin. You'll ask it at the end.
Yeah, well, Kevin.
We'll bring it in there.
Well, at the end, you can only ask what's going on in the meeting.
Right. We're going to move on to the co-option item E, which is the co-option agenda item. We've had two candidates make their statements at the last meeting. I believe we've got a third candidate, Mr. Bentley. Do you want to stand up and make your co-option speak?
Yes, indeed. Thank you very much indeed, Mr. Chairman. I'm just wondering whether I wish to continue with the heated arguments that have been going on. First of all, thank you very much indeed for giving me this opportunity to address you all. It's been my intention several times in the past 30 years that I and my family have been residents in the parish to stand as a prospective candidate. But my service initially in Her Majesty's Armed Forces and latterly in various government departments has precluded me from that really because of time commitments and being frequently out of the country, that I could not give my time sufficiently to the needs of the parish, that I think that parish residents would rightly expect from a councillor. In the 30 years that I've resided in the parish, I've involved myself, however, several times in matters which have involved life within the parish, and mostly where I've been at loggerheads to some degree with the borough council. Several years ago, I was instrumental in persuading a telecommunications company to not to locate a rather large tower in the grounds of Greenland School.
Can you just ask you to switch that off, please, Mr. Smith?
I can talk over that. Just to reiterate that on the mobile communications tower in Greenland School. We did this by persuading governors and parents to oppose the offer from that company. Later, I was a major campaigner in opposing the local authority in selling the sports field of Greenland School. And I suppose I declare an interest there that I live directly opposite it. And we did this by canvassing directly all borough councillors into opposing it, and we managed to change their mind on it. Currently, I'm involved in redressing, or attempting to redress, the appalling management of Anston Plantation, which has become an ongoing cause of concern for those who have property boundaries directly onto the plantation, in line with ladies' concerns about the poor management of it and the surveying of it, and the fact that there are numerous trees in a very unsafe condition now. I created an online petition using Rotherham Council's website, and we managed to obtain 54 signatories of residents who have a common boundary with the plantation. And I was able, fortunately, to convince the newly appointed commissioner of RMBC into the shortcomings and attitudes of some of her staff. To her credit, she has set in place an independent report into these complaints and into the state of woodlands in RMBC area. We eagerly await the results of this this report, which is in draft form with the council from the contractor at the moment, and I'm assured that we will hear very, very shortly about the improvements to that. So that's basically all I'd like to say to keep it very brief this evening. Other than to say, I'm a great believer in local democracy, especially policing and environmental matters. And I believe that given the personal responsibilities that exist for parish councillors, I believe that given the opportunity to become a member of this council, I will discharge my responsibilities well. Thank you for the opportunity to address you.
Thank you. Do you, Mrs. Smallen or Mr. Crocker want to?
I would like to say one more thing. The short statement is still with the commissioners in Rotherham. Now, some people here may know that I have had a running battle against abuse against my severely disabled son for years.
Can she have a microphone?
I'm sorry, but this is relevant to the co-option process.
I think it
process.
Is. It is. I think the relevance here is that I've been in touch with councillors over the time. Councillors, not parish as such, but councillors from Rotherham who actually sat on this parish council. I've been in touch with MPs. I've been in touch with the last government, this government, not just for my son, but for the abuse on disabled people that carried out in Rotherham. And I got absolutely nowhere. I've since found out that all the paperwork that was available has been scrapped by Rotherham Borough Council. the same as those girls. I went to commissioners, I actually got to see a commissioner. I actually got to see Professor Graham Betts, who's now head of adult. I'm very passionate about this. Because I know that my son wasn't the only one who was nearly killed by being in Rotherham Borough Council care. And I hate them for it. At long last, it's taken me years. I have now a letter from the commissioners apologising for the abuse that my son had and the fact that it's upset his health. It's killed mine. And believe you me, if I fought. I fought, I've written, I've addressed people, I've had hold of them in the street, that's an MP. In fact, I taught Kevin Baranoff at church. And believe you me, my son was sitting in my house with me on a little holiday when it came on the television about those girls. And he looked at me and I looked at him and we just cried. Because nobody listens to the disabled and what's happened to them. Okay. And you've got no idea how much I've fallen.
I'm going to ask you to finish.
I will finish.
Mr. Grocock, do you want to?
Thank you.
I feel as you did speak last time. Nothing to add from what you said last time. If you want to, as I say, if you want to, you've got the opportunity to say a few more words. Okay, everybody? Do that, finished. Okay,
we'll move on then. Can I ask a question?
What we're going to. Yeah, you can, yeah, if you want this question, yeah.
Hello, Mr. Bentley.
Hello.
Why have you suddenly taken an interest in parish council politics when I've never seen you here at a parish council meeting?
You would have seen me here back in 85 and 86 when I was opposing some planning applications that were enforced. Yeah. No, recently, as I said in my introduction, that I've unfortunately been unable to provide the time. I believe that councillors must be able to devote a considerable amount of time to the residents of the parish, and unfortunately my employment has taken me frequently out of the country and I couldn't guarantee continuity. The sole reason.
Thank you.
Anybody else got any questions? Any candidates? John?
It's not a question, it's just a thank you for my son attends Honest Agreement School, and obviously we've got a great playing field, and if it weren't for your efforts, then it may do something else.
Thank you very much.
Anybody else, Joe?
The way for this thing to turn itself on. Just a question for all the candidates, actually. So one of the things that I personally value about this council is the fact that it's independent and hopefully apolitical. Now, I'll ask, you're obviously not obliged to answer, but are any of the people standing for co-option members of political parties?
I'm not, no.
I am. No. But that's up to me, because I agree with you. A parish council should be for the parish, not the political party.
Mr. Grove, no. Right, thank you. And others? Okay. Right, thank you very much indeed.
Excuse me, Chairman. On behalf of this lady, just for clarity, Mr. Bailey mentioned Amston Plantation.
Mr. Bentley.
beg his pardon. Sorry, Mr. Bentley.
Sorry.
He mentioned Amston Plantation. It's nothing to do with this lady. That Amston Plantation is on Nursery Road for everybody's benefit, and these ladies are at Crowgate in South Amston. Okay. Not Crowgate, well, I suppose it is.
Okay, Crowgate. Thank you for your clarification. Right, I'm going to close the public session. I'm going to move into the council meeting itself. Everybody's got a copy of the rules and regulations, or the front of them, I should have. So item one, to receive apologies for absence. The council should be aware that a member who fails to attend a meeting with the authority over a continuous period of 6 months shall cease to be a member of that authority unless previously approved. Local Government Act 1972. Yes, he has to be. That's Councillor Machen. Can't get any, whether he's realised later.
I have an answer to my question.
So that he might arrive later on.
I beg your pardon?
I said he may arrive later on, Councillor.
Okay.
Councillor Machen.
Yes.
Well, I thought we'd gone through that actually. I'm not going back to that, unfortunately.
Oh, okay.
I've done miles.
Oh, right. Well,
item
one
two.
Rule for one and one for another.
Hillary, please.
No.
Item two, to disclose members of the EPI or personally interested in any item to be discussed.
Item seven, local option. I know this is more as an acquaintance.
Any others? Jonathan?
Do you know of her, John? I'm not going to be caring interesting in.
It's a small one, but...
Well, 12-1, it's only that for myself. And 13-4, because my wife's on the Anson Day Festival Committee for this year.
And 13-3, because I'm mentioning it.
Oh, yes, same.
So, sorry, what was that the other game, Jonathan?
13-4. If you mention another item, is that of interest as well?
Well, if you want to do that, that's up to you.
Well, yes, I'm not interested in myself.
John, did you want to be clear? You're not.
I just said 13-3 because I'm mentioning it.
I'm going to class that as an interest because you mentioned it.
We seem to always mention everything, so we've enjoyed it.
Miles?
13-4, because I'm on that committee now.
That it?
No.
It's Chris, or sorry?
I know, this is more.
Right, okay. That's co-option again, I need to. Okay, item three, to identify items which the present board may be excluded from public bodies are issued to meetings at 1960, session 1 and number 2. We've got 4, item 0. Any others, anybody?
Section 19.
Any others, anywhere? Gordon, you've got a dispensation for the allotment, haven't you?
Yeah.
And have you? Well, you know,
well, it's regarding Southampton, the law, so okay. I've
got any others
in Southampton. Very good.
Okay. If anything strikes anybody's removed towards it, you can just shout out.
Could you speak up? These ladies
sorry,
are here.
I do apologise, I've not got the other microphone on, so...
You're not
working okay, item four, to elect a vice chairman of the parish council. Can I have any nomination? Offers?
I'd like to nominate Drew as the new vice chair. Sorry, councillor.
Use the microphone.
Sorry about that. I'd like to nominate councillor Carmey as vice chair.
Can I sign up, chair, if anybody else is interested?
Just don't say if anybody else.
Anybody else?
Interested.
I'm interested, but I can't have any sock, can I?
No, you can't. You can declare an interest.
Anybody else? Councillor Carmey. Have you got a second for Councillor Carmey? I've got to ask first, are you willing to accept the position if you were voted on? You've got a second for me, you've got a second for
Councillor
you might propose a seconder for Jonathan.
I'll propose Jonathan.
Got a seconder?
I'll second him.
Okay.
I think that's a bit
just a good answer. Yeah, right, we can do it.
One word.
No, it isn't the wrong word.
You can just vote for one for member, so we'll do Councillor Tarmy first. Apologies for the expression. You'll vote on Councillor Tarmy first, not do Councillor Tarmy. Sound quite right, that is it. All those.
Speak up, Clive, they can't hear you.
I'm sorry, I don't. How high do you want me to speak?
Well,
for the
shout.
Yeah, sorry, well, I can hear you.
Well,
and
I'm
sure everybody else
can. Yes,
yeah.
And I've told
Hillary, thank you. Do you want to put your name forward for vice chair?
Oh, I do. I could put my name forward for chair.
Garden vote, so you're not on the council, so. Could you just be quiet, please? Can we take a vote on that? All those favourite councillor Tarmy being the vice chair? We've got that. Do you want to? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many is that? 9. That's carried.
Yes.
So that's carried. Sorry?
I think that's wrong procedure, Chairman. You've got to take the votes for one.
Well, all right.
But not off the, because you've not given anyone the opportunity to vote for the second.
But you can't vote for two, can you?
No, so you've got to.
Still an overall majority, nine. Well, we'll vote on Jonathan Islands.
No, I think.
Can we decide? Okay, all those in favour of Councillor Ireland? 1, 2, 3. You can actually vote, yeah.
I promise I'll still that
vote. 4.
That's how I'll stay.
4. So that's 9 votes for Councillor Tarmy and 4 votes for Councillor Ireland. Councillor Tarmy is elected vice chair.
Excellent democracy.
Now you've got to sit back and do this.
You don't have to sign anything else, Drew, you're all right. Item 5, confirm it's a Parish Council meeting held on Wednesday, 3rd of February 2016.
Resolved that the budget was accepted and the next one resolved that the precept was accepted, and that was on the 3rd of February. That's
what can you use the microphone?
Yes, I will.
Thank you.
If these are about the minutes of the 3rd of February, am I correct?
Yes.
Well, 339/15 budget resolved, the budget, and 340/15 the precept was resolved. So they've already been passed and done.
Well,
nobody's querying that. The question I asked was, why wasn't the figure of the precept recorded, and what was the final figure that we voted for?
262. Well, the precept was 262/750. He said here.
I'm sorry.
It was the percentage figure.
We've gone through this. It's all been approved and decided. If you want it, it'll be put on the website or anywhere else.
I'm asking for clarification, because there was quite a lot of confusion at that meeting, and some councillors still don't know what the percentage rise was in the precept. So I'm asking again, please. What was the percentage rise in the precept that we agreed as the last bit?
They were on that sheet that was handed out to council with that figure decided. We've approved the budget, and as far as I'm concerned, right.
I believe the rise in precept is 1.9%. Well, we clearly, as a council,
we've agreed that at the end of the day, there was no increase in the tax, the council taxes would be paid. We've all agreed that. We took the vote on it.
We agreed a precept, a nil precept, in the previous meeting, and I just wanted to confirm that we actually agreed a 1.1% increase. But some councils around this table voted for that, and they didn't have a clue what they were voting for.
I'm sorry, but we've discussed that, we voted on it, the minutes have been approved.
Just means to add that we're not paying any more for Amsterdam.
Right, so, sorry. You know a lot, John, then, so what was the precept rise that we probably
missed? It was just over 1%, because of tax allowances from whatever job was, which I don't quite clear, I'm not supposed to understand.
Tax base.
I'm not an accountant. All I just know is that the figures.
I'm sorry.
We accepted them, I accepted them, a lot of others accepted them. So move on, Chair, please.
Yeah, I'm sorry, we're not having any more discussion. Stuart, please. I'm going to move on now. Move on to item 7, which is to consider co-option. So if you want to go, members want to go out through the bottom left hand door this time, to the bottom of the other hall to discuss it.
Clive?
You're stopping it?
Yes.
Okay, that's fine.
Well, it's only us that's saying it.
Well, you wouldn't have that one.
Yes.
Right.
Well, more hour open, or is the council man taking on?
Yeah.
bought the mince. Right, okay. Everybody, I'm going to go through all the candidates one by one, and I'm going to ask for a proposer and a seconder for each one. And then we take a vote. I'm going to go through the candidates one by one, I'm going to ask for a proposer and a seconder, and then a vote for each candidate. Is that the right way? Yeah. Okay, just clarification. So, Mr. Bateman, you have a proposer and a seconder. Mr. Bentley, proposer and seconder, please. Miles, Stewart. Mr. Grocock, proposer and seconder. No. And Mrs. Morn, as proposer and seconder.
Proposer.
Thank you. Right, we're just going to vote on the three people and one candidate only out of the three. So, per vote, sorry. So it's Mr. Bateman. So, in the first vote, all those, there, Mr. Bateman, 1, 2. Mr. Bentley. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Mr. Grothrox, eliminated. Mrs. Moore. 1, 2. That's yeah. So, Mrs. Moore is eliminated. I'm sorry, I'm going to vote on the other two candidates. Sorry, we're going to vote on the other two candidates. First one is Mr. Bateman.
Mr. Bateman, Mr. Bentley. Mr. Bateman hasn't
appeared,
has he?
No, but that we're still. Where is he having? Yeah, he's not. No, he's not here, but that can stop us voting. So can I have a vote again for Mr. Bateman? Mr. Bateman.
We're now going on to
Mrs. Jensen, she's not here.
Mr. Bateman and Mr. Bentley.
You eliminated? Yes, yeah, we've eliminated two. We land down to two.
So now we've voted.
Well, it's Mr. Bateman, Mr. Bentley. It's Mr. Bentley.
Yes, yeah, Mr. Bateman.
Darren, that's 2, 3.
What's that?
Mr. Bateman. All those in favour, Mr. Bateman. John? No? We've just had three people put their hands up in favour of Mr. Bateman. Mr. Bentley. 3, 4, 5, 7. Hang on, one, just gone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right, that's sorted out. Mr. Bentley co-opted. If he wants to come forward and sign his paperwork,
may I just say congratulations?
And leave his policies.
No, I can't. Sorry.
Probably had it already, is he?
Might be best out of it, at least.
Right, so
Mr. Bateman, you're on your own.
Right. event.
Can I just quickly ask you which part of the armed forces are you?
I was in both the army and the Navy. Okay. We've got a little passage, signed, sealed, and delivered. Okay,
can you ride a skateboard?
I'm going to move on to item A.
Sandra?
I'm going to move on to item A to approve payments to sign cheques, approve grant to you all, higher, if any.
You need a chair.
Sorry. To approve payments. Yeah, I'd like to thank the other applicants for attending and putting the names forward. And say if we talk again in future, then there's nothing to stop anybody putting the names forward again. Like,
I think it'd be protocol before, Chair, that the second time, if you want another one, the original ones, all they had to do was say they were still interested.
Yes,
they
yeah, that's
application
right.
Again.
So you only have to say that you would like your name left on the file as such, to be fair with a better option.
Yeah, you may as well put my name on the file.
We will consider it along with anybody else, okay? Right, got your paper in front of you, everybody. Oh dear. Everybody got this piece of paper in front of them? We've got the checks in front of you. Any questions?
If you're doing surfing the net, the hard phone.
Hillary, please.
Well,
come on, that's.
What are they doing here, giggling, looking at that?
I have no idea, but it's out of order actually saying that.
Well, maybe.
So, can I just ask you to please keep quiet? It's not on, and making comments like that is not on either. I'm not sure what they're...
Messing about that's not either fine.
I know it is, but I expect that they'll sort themselves out and we'll go through this properly.
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody got any points to raise? While we're at it. Stuart, do you want to sit down? Any comments? Everybody happy with those? Mr. Bentley, do you want to? Are you all right with them?
No, I'm still myself
in. All right, okay. Can we propose a seconder, please? Jonathan, Colin, all those in favour, please show. Thank you. All higher grants, no grants. Item 9, consider grants, none again. Item 10, consider planning, licensing, matters, transfer issues and receive reports. 10.1, planning list, list 5, item 00695, Orchard Avenue, extension. Any comments?
We just leave that to the end.
There was a plan list. List 5, item 00892, Kemble Avenue, demolition extension. That's the very interesting this afternoon. No further interest. Everybody okay with that? Again, neighbours and planners. So it's straightforward, single story extension. List 6, item 0119, 1 Peacock Lane, pruned tree. Put it again. Yeah. Plus any further items shown on planning list published by RBC up to and including the day of the meeting. 2, to receive and discuss notification of request for scope and opinion regarding Harry Croft. Colliery. We need to...
Quarry,
sorry. Colliery, do you mean? Sure. We're back too far there, John. We did have this at the last meeting. I asked people if they would have a look at it on the planning website. I don't know if anybody has. I have. Nobody else has. If I could just bring members up to speed, this is an application by Tarmac, back into the fire, I think, just Tarmac are the actual applicants. And this is to extend the planning permission from December 2016 to December 2031. And the restoration work from December 2018 to December 2032. And it involves extracting 200,000 tonnes of limestone aggregate per annum until 2031. Preserving several million tonnes that are still there.
Can I
just finish this? Having gone through the applications of RNBC, they've got a landscape request from the council and also a transport statement, the one from tarmac, as to what their intentions are regarding pollution, traffic issues, etc., etc. As I said, it's 200,000 tonnes of limestone to be extracted over the next 15 years. It's up to members what they, if they want to make comments. It's not really to object to the application, it's any comments that we think of relevant to Anston, and particularly South Anston, that will affect it.
I was just going to ask, it says a request for scoping option. Is it an actual planning application, or is that to follow?
I think it outlines what they want to do and what they're going to be asked to do by the local authority. They wanted to extend that, whether it be that it's the scope of the works. Because that application runs out in December this year, and then they want to extend it to 2031.
Because I imagine they would have. Because to me, a request for a scoping option is not a planning application.
But it has actually got a planning application number. It's just a different variation. It's not a straightforward building application. It's for extraction of minerals, and they have to still get a planning application permission for that.
Are we on a time frame on this?
Yeah.
They asked for this last time when they finished to extend the amount of time that they could do it. But is there any mention in it? I can't see anything in it. Account of backfill.
Yes.
Is it in?
It's in again, yeah.
Fine.
I think the thing about that is they're supposed to restore it, which means backfill.
Yeah.
The comment made by RNBC was that they'd given a year to backfill it.
That's right.
That was long enough, given the amount they're going to extract over the next 15 years.
Because they get paid for the stuff they take out, they get paid for the
stuff. That's part of the planning approval that's backfilled and landscaped and all whatever.
I'm sure they say Jim Elliwell does.
Just
for a number, that's 40 loaders on the line.
Yeah, it's 20, I think it's
20. You mean 90 on vehicles?
That's what, yeah.
Sorry. 40 loader on.
Well, a baggage is going from there.
Baggage.
We've been working on that. They've got to give that assessment because Rotherham will ask for vehicle trips, etc., etc. So that will be an additional transport statement that the company will supply. All I want us to do tonight, sorry Paul, is just decide what comments we want to make about that extraction and what effect we think it will have on the village, and that those concerns are taken into account.
Paul? I was just going to say, working on 38 tonnes per truck. 5,300 loads.
Can't carry 38 ton.
Working on an average of 38.
We can't. We can only carry 25 ton on road.
25 ton. That's all the 10
so it's 40 load a month. You can actually carry 40 ton.
No, we've got.
No, you cannot.
Well, we're not debating the weight of lorries, unfortunately. We're trying to work out what effect it's going to have on the roads, South Anston, Anston Stones, etc.
I just mentioned it soon. How many vehicles a month are going to go through the village?
Well, they will have to put that to Rotherham because they have asked for all those trip numbers and everything else to be supplied before they approve it at the end there. So they've got to come up with an assessment of what number of vehicles will get going through South Anston towards works or whichever way. But it's not going to be an inconsiderable number for that way.
Mr. Chair,
sorry.
Regarding the sort of environment, as that's one of the things I outlined I have a specific interest in, the initial planning application must have had an environmental impact assessment.
This one has as well. One has as well.
Does it have a separate environmental impact?
Yeah, it's got assessment. Ecology, it's all listed on the website. If you go to the planning number, it's all there.
That's fine.
Good.
Yeah, I think as a council, we should raise the point, to consideration the numbers. From what we're saying, probably 10 a week. RNBC have already made it known that the junction at South Anston there, the crossroads, needs improvement. and have done that in planning applications that was submitted for an industrial site at Gateford. So I think we should also raise a concern about if the junction needs improving, we'd like to know what the impact on the junction is going to be, the crossroads. And the other one is, which direction are the quarry in? Because, again, I raised at last meeting, is there was a lot of concern about the blasting they were doing, and it was affecting all the inhabitants of South Anston who live nearby, said their houses were rumbling with the blasting. So if they're going towards South Anston, that's a grave concern to the houses of South Anston. If they're going the other way, or...
I'm not sure. I looked at the plans, I'm not sure whether... I think it indicated if they were going south of us that way.
Towards the canal.
I think the extraction depth is 8, they're going down to 18 metres, I think. Yeah. It's all listed on the planning outline that we've put it for. So it's about 6-7 pages long. It's quite easy to read, but if you read other information, it tells you what the council asked for as well to back that application. Yeah. But you're right about the traffic lights, they're doing it sort of in South Hampton, it's terrible. But the council are looking to do that from section 106 or CIL when that starts to come through.
So can we raise a concern about the effect on South Hampton, i.e. if they're doing blasting?
I think, yeah, I mean, I can get Michael's right, and we need to have got an extension until Friday, I think it's coming. I think 8/19, we've got an extension from them. I think the council's still in discussions directly with the company, but we can get those off. I think we have to raise concerns about the air quality, traffic, effect on that triple SI, etc., etc. And also, as I said, the traffic situation through South Anston. What I would also like to ask if we can contact Tarmac Qualifiers and have a meeting with them once this moves on. I think we've done that before. Looking at you, John, I think I was present to meetings with them, but I think
the idea was that they were going southwards towards First Lane because there was a restriction of distance from the back of Hawthorne Avenue because that's where the bungalow had been affected, of 100 metres. They're not there yet. You know, 50 metres probably within that 50, but I understood it was going that way.
I think from looking at plans, that was my impression, but I'm not.
Because they can't go that way, anyway. And they can't go this way because it's only 57.
Can't go down. Is everybody agreed that we write to the planning authority just expressing our concerns and that we could get in the consultation and that we would like maybe like a meeting with Tarmac Lafarge at some point in the future to discuss what those proposed issues. Okay, is everybody happy with that as a run forward? Yeah. Yeah, can I just have a short answer on that? Everybody in favour of doing that route with Tarmac Lafarge? Thank you. Item 11, to authorise sealing of documents, daily grants of expensive rights of burial for the Anston Burial Ground. No. Item 12, consider matters from previous meetings. 12.1, discuss receiving email from Council at the meeting on the 16th November 2015.
Chairman.
Yeah.
Can I withdraw that item? It's from November.
If you wish to, John,
can I make a comment on it?
Well, I've withdrawn the item.
You've withdrawn it because you don't want to be criticised. Let me tell you something. You've been very disrespectful in this meeting.
When you command respect to it, you can have it all.
No problem. If you're going to carry on insulting me in these meetings, there will be consequences.
Come on then.
Making comments to councillors, I apologise for lowering my
vote. Jonathan's withdrawn the item.
I find that highly offensive.
Come on, he's withdrawn the item. There's no further
discussion. Mr.
Councillor Bentley has not signed up to take part in all this. I'm sure he'd like to get on with the job he now. Well, it's withdrawn now, and that's the end of it.
It shows his integrity.
Thank you. We'll move on. We'll move on. Can I just ask the audience to keep quiet, please? Item 12.2, to receive letter from Durham University and discuss approved further excavation and stone wood. Also content consent notice from Natural England.
Clive?
Yeah, Miles?
I just asked, I mean, they mentioned at the bottom that we're to give a lecture. Can we provide a venue for it?
Yeah.
Sorry, what did you say, Miles?
Yeah, let's just go to the bit, the first bit then, Miles, and we'll get that out of the way, which is to receive a letter and discuss approved further excavation. Is everybody happy for that?
No.
Can I just
come in?
That was a reserve. Right, for those that don't know, Mr. Mark White, Professor Mark White from Durham University, he came and did an archaeological dig last year in the Stones Wood. They did a dig just below the ridge at Deadman's Cave, and then on, I can't remember quite right, but on the other side of the valley. Did he give us a short brief of what they found? But it wasn't very much. And he's requesting to come back again this summer to investigate the mini gorge that runs parallel to the main ravine above past Deadman's Cave. I first will say, I met him, he's quite a nice guy. I was going to try and get some publicity, and he was quite happy to have some publicity for the parish council, some positive publicity that was beaten to it by the Guardian. I would recommend that we ask him to come back and do some archaeological work. He seems to think that the Stones Wood may be, or he's trying to find evidence to see if it's linked in some way to Creswell Crags, which is a World Heritage Site.
So, you work in conjunction.
Thank you. Sorry, Hillary, please, let's get him finished.
I think it's a positive thing all around, and I think we should say yes, let's invite him back again.
I think we passed in the previous meeting, Chair, that we would, in fact, ask him to come and give a lecture. We had one of the councillors, I think it was you, Frank, that you asked for more information from him. I think it was you, yes, it was. And we said that we would ask them to come back and give a presentation to us all on what they're doing and what they've done.
And if you look through the rest of the letter, it says this year we may be in a position to give a local lecture, if that would interest anybody. Yeah, yeah. We can broaden that out, actually.
Yeah.
We can broaden that out to members of the public as well, not just councillors. Yeah, I think other people that live in the village should be aware. So, can I have a proposal and a second then that we agree to him coming back? Sorry, Colin, I'll do beg your pardon. Can I just have a proposal and a second for Stuart, me, right, and Colin, to you, thank you.
Colin.
Thank you. It says in the letter here, the report attached to that email explained the rationale behind the investigation. Where's the report?
We've had it before.
Have we?
We had it. This was a result of.
There is a copy of it, but it's not all included because it's quite a large report. But we did get it last year.
Can it not be paraphrased down a bit?
I think there's 10 pages, I think, Colin, so it's fairly, I'm not going to attempt to...
Would you be able to put it up on a board in the parish hall?
I think we just have to be mindful of what and where they're working, because we don't want... Everybody at the gamble is interrupting the dig. So
I'm talking about the one they've done.
Yeah, but I'm just I agree with that. I'm just having a look through whether we can
email it.
Well, let's have. Can we do that? Yes. Yeah, if you want an emailed copy, we'll send that and get that sent out to everybody. It is quite a long report. A lot of it. It's fairly technical, but we can do that, that's not a problem.
Could I get an email then, please?
Yeah, we'll send it out to all councillors. Not a problem.
Is it a report on their findings of their previous dig?
I'm sorry, yeah, it is, Hillary, just to clarify.
What you keep talking about with that? Afternoon,
I know.
Do you want a copy, Hillary?
Yes, I do.
We'll ask the chair.
Will I have a copy, please? I'll have a hard copy.
Right, we'll send that out to councillors.
And?
I'll wait to what?
I'll send it on to you, Laura.
It's not a confidential item, information, is it?
I should hope not.
Well, I'm just...
If there's any confidential information, I'm not...
well, it's secret at the minute, because nobody's seen it.
It's not secret at all.
Well, why have we seen it, Clive?
Because we don't want people tramping on the side.
We're talking about the one that's gone. We can't tramp on it when it's last year.
Can I just... Drew, would you like to speak, please?
Just to pick up on that point.
Vice Chair, somebody.
Can we check with Professor Wine whether it is in public domain?
Yeah.
Because if it contains unpublished research findings, he might not be terribly happy about it being distributed.
Hey, if they find a skeleton, it might be a crime scene.
Well, we'll do that. I'll get the gladness to clarify with Professor White that it's okay for that to be put out in the wider domain, and then we'll take it from there. We'll see what his opinion is. Because I don't know whether it might be used for any other research, but it's confidential. So we'll check that out first, and then let people know. Chris?
I would like generally, please, Clive, for information to be made available to the general public, as well as councillors. There's lots of stuff we don't get.
We will do. As I said, we need to check with him that it's not...
Yeah, I'm just saying, in general, if we could bear it in mind, please. We are working for the people of Anston. We've a right to tell them what's going on.
Stuff is sent out to councillors primarily, not to members of the public in the first instance. Anything that's of public interest will be put in the minutes or whatever else it can be accessible.
No, I don't mean to that extent, Clive. I mean to include the public, include the schools. This is very important for the schools.
Well,
they probably don't know anything about it.
It's very difficult. If councillors want to take that on themselves and communicate with the school, then that's fine.
Yes, I will.
You're able to do that. But we'll get that clarification from Professor White first to make sure anything that's released doesn't go in somebody else's thesis as to what is... what he's found.
I don't think it's a thesis, Clive.
Oh, okay. Right, can
it's
we...
an excavation.
A public who are interested, when they do know, they do give help loads of times.
Yeah.
Help out with things that you've not known about.
The trouble is that is you've got to be a specialist in the field to do that, Sandra, unfortunately.
No, they ask the public, often an archaeological needs to go and help.
Can I just ask, please, don't keep chipping in. I'm trying to get the meeting, give councillors a chance to actually... speak. Can I? What have you got on the table, Mike? We've agreed. The proposal and second is to ask them to come back and carry on the work. Can I have all those in favour of that, please? Thank you.
Have you got it down to make the report available, please?
Yeah, go on to the second part of that. And the other bit is that we would like him, if possible, to give a lecture on the work. Whenever it's acceptable, he could do it, and we'll include members of the public in that lecture if we can. Everybody happy with that as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a step forward, giant step for mankind.
12.3, consider pest control contract.
I've asked this before, Clive. Why do you want to kill the moles?
Because it's unsightly in the cemetery for people to go.
Sure, cemetery.
What?
Well,
I don't think that's a good enough reason to kill moles.
Well,
because they make hills.
I think the cemetery will be messed up.
Yeah, it undermines the gravestones, and there's the possibility that the stones could fall on children or anything, which they haven't done in workshop.
Have you had any instances in the past of that?
We haven't, but they're
no.
in workshop.
Well, you can't just kill moles in case.
Moles.
That what?
In case.
No, sorry.
What I mean is...
If, not in Thurtrow Cemetery.
Please, let's
if you could inspect the cemetery, and if they do look likely to cause trouble, then yes.
Chris, yeah, that's what I do.
But I don't think you can just indiscriminately kill the moles.
Can I ask a question first? How did this contract for the cemetery has been running for over a year now, I think? Or a year? How many moles have been killed?
About 2 months.
Two?
A month.
Two a month.
Two a month.
I'm actually...
There are no mowers.
Right, I'm actually against...
Because he's catching them all.
It's catching my
own. I'm actually against...
please, please, this is not, it's not an open forum. Stuart, you want to carry on? Val, come on.
I'm actually against actually killing the walls, in the sense that there's no requirement for it. They can be tracked live and then released, should we say, somewhere more appropriate. What we should be doing is, as soon as the moles have been trapped live and taken elsewhere, the mole hills then should be levelled, because it affects when you mow the lawn, mow the grass. But you can't capture them, you level the mole hill.
No, but I'm saying you can't cut the grass when there's moles.
I don't think it's worth the money killing these moles. Because I suggest what we do is, we get our workers to go up there, but we go out and buy a trap, and we go up there, and we trap them live and release them somewhere. So yeah, I'm going to propose that we terminate the contract.
How much time are our workers going to spend up there trying to catch it?
We won't know until we try it, Clive.
I made a proposal.
I second the proposal. Just let me get
some semblance of order. Do you propose?
My proposal is to terminate the contract, and in future we task our own parish workers to trap the moles as required.
I'll second that.
Could I ask another question?
Yeah.
Well, maybe Mike could answer this. What qualifications do our workers have in trapping animals?
None.
That's my question.
Mr. Bentley, or Councillor Bentley.
Can I just add something on the legality of that, actually? It depends entirely on the classification of the furry animal itself, whether it's a vermin or a pest, whether you capture it and release it, because certain types of vermin, it's an illegal act to release them back into the wild after you have captured them. So another point on that is maybe the contractors at the moment are using humane methods to discourage the moles there, and that they are... The fact that we have such a low capture rate as it was, that maybe they are being successful in their contract.
Can I just ask, are they catching two moles a month every month? Or is it just two moles every now and then? You said two moles.
Well, I was understanding it was two a month. But there are, at this point in time, as far as I can remember going up there, there are no moles. It used to be absolutely full of moles in the cemetery, absolutely.
What I would suggest is that we try for 12 months. And if you're catching two moles a month and release them into the wild as such, then fine.
Release them somewhere else.
We've got a proposal that we've contrast terminated the contract. Can I just say, if they reappear, then we'll have people want to renew the contract. I'll just make one comment. If we get lots of comments from members of public saying it's an absolute disgrace. All those in favour of terminating the contract? And asking our workers to trap them all. We can't ask him if we can, do we? All those against?
You're going to keep defending on training.
All those against?
Come on,
Kevin. So that motion failed. So we bring back to
you. Know, the mother's grave.
Sorry, Sandra, please.
We don't put a bit of paraffin on the end of a rag.
I'm sorry. Sandra, please. If you carry on, I'm going to have to ask you to leave the meeting. I'm going to keep interrupting because we're not getting further forward.
That four.
Now, the next one is, are we going to renew the contract to Mole King?
Can we leave it for a while?
I've got
Well, the proposal's there to renew the contract. Now, there's a bit of proposal.
When is the contract up?
Sorry?
When is the contract up?
It's up now.
I've got to make a decision. I've just made a proposal to terminate.
Yeah.
If you now make a proposal to renew the contract, does that not negate my first proposal? The proposal is directly negated my proposal.
It's fallen already. Can I have the question is to consider pest control contract 2016 to renew it. Can I have a proposal? Jonathan, have a second.
I'll second
to renew it. Go on. All those in favour renewing the contract. All those against?
What's happened, Clive? I didn't catch it. Sorry.
Renewed.
It's renewed.
Yeah. What I will do. I'm sorry.
Well, it is relevant.
I'm sorry, Hilary. Can I just finish? What I will do, I'll ask the guy that's doing the work to keep reporting back to us as to what he's finding up there.
Yeah.
And anything else, any further information you can give us, we'll bring that to council with something monitored, because people have obviously got feelings about it.
Yeah. But
we'll take on board comments from members of the public as well. If we do get moles up there that, you know, people don't like in that area, so we'll do that and we'll bring that back on a sort of reporting basis.
Okay. Thank you.
Can I make a proposal that we ask Councillor Thornton to investigate his proposal further and come back to council with some costings?
For you
propose training the workers, you propose getting some other means of dealing with the loss. Could you put something together and see if it's viable, see if it's legal?
I'll look into it, I'll look into it.
Just bear with me. Is it going to contribute to the discussion?
Yeah.
Go on then, quickly.
When this was first mooted, I did ask what method there was going to be used to control these moles, should we say, because I objected to an act to killing them. And I had a letter, I've still got it on file, I had a letter from the contractor assuring me that the moles wouldn't be killed, that they will be dealt with humanely. Now, is that the same in this contract?
I don't know if I'm, because I've not the if it's the same gentleman who said that, then I presume he will still be trying to do that way.
Well, that's not answering my question.
Well, I don't know the answer to your question.
Well, you've got something in front of you.
All I've got is a bit of paper.
Not
just
a small word.
I mean, there's no need to kill them. You only have to put something in.
Well, put it this way, we need.
You only have to put something in the mold run, and they'll go elsewhere.
Okay, right, that's fine. Thank you.
So how what?
I don't know how far this is Estrada. I can't answer that. I'm not going to do. Sorry, we're moving on to item 12.4, please. I haven't got the information in front of me.
What do we pay this man, Clive?
Sorry? It's not for public discussion, that's a contractual matter. Can I move on? Make progress, thank you.
Drew's happy, Sam.
Sorry, Drew. What else?
Just forgotten.
I was just going to say, I thought it might be helpful that the contractor, I remember in some previous documentation that he said confirmed that the moles were gassed.
That's totally different to what he sent me, and I have it on file.
You may make a film.
Right, sorry, I'm going to move on now to 12.4 to approve amendment. To approve amendment to Standing Order 105 in order to acknowledge contracts regulations 2015.
Can I just clarify? Did we bring this to a previous meeting and it's been on the agenda more than a month?
Yes. It's it's just legislation, so we have no choice when it attacks that.
Something that has to be done, so...
So which part of the, just for everybody's notification, which part are we actually changing and approving? So it's paragraph...
It's...
The last part of paragraph...
Bottom of paragraph 105, and then... The bottom three lines where it says 105.5, which is in light and grey, or not light. You got that?
I've got it, yeah. So everybody knows what we're going to
vote for. And 105.B. I don't think we have no choice but to accept it. Yeah. It is regulation. No.
Can I propose that we accept the amendment as shown?
Second. All those in favour, please show. Thank you. 12.5, to approve an amendment to financial regulation 10.3 to acknowledge the public contracts regulation 2015. This is the same. Yeah, over the page 10.3, the figures are in there that it refers to. Line 1, 2, 3, 4 down.
Right, can I ask you another question?
There's an increase in the figure.
Do these figures include or exclude creating?
I don't know. Yeah, probably
exclusive.
But that's just what you set out in the regulations. So, I'm proposing a second. Can I set that, please? Phil? Yeah. Jonathan, all those in favour? Accepted, please. Thank you. Item 12.6, consider letter from Resident Young Tree on Anstey Village Green.
That's me. That's my letter.
Sorry, please, if you keep quiet.
Yeah. Ooh. Can't hear you, Drew.
Have we got anything in place to make sure that retrospective applications aren't put in the future?
I would assume so. After dialogue with RMBC, that will be noted, their comments, and it will be put in place. I'm sorry, we know it's your letter, but Mr. Bentley's probably not had a chance to read it, he's only seen it.
No, I'm going to give him a copy.
He's got a copy, thanks. He's got a copy, thanks.
Go on, Stuart.
Can I come in?
Yeah.
First of all, has the planning permission been granted?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
It doesn't say retrospective, does it?
No.
On the planning. Why is that?
Let's just say what I think has happened here. Is more important, equally important, is not the issue of the tree being felled, it's the way the council handled the issue afterwards. The tree shouldn't have been felled, this is my opinion, the tree shouldn't have been felled in the first place, and I honestly believe it was done by mistake by one of the parish workers. So I personally...
How can you fell a tree by mistake, Stuart?
Christine, let him finish, please.
Well, excuse me.
Sorry, but will you let him finish?
I don't think it was done for any malicious intent.
For heaven's sake.
It was done for a reason, but we agree or not, it's a different matter. It's how we handled it afterwards. And I think we didn't handle it very well at all. We said the tree had been pollarded. It hadn't. There was lots of discussion around this table about whether the area was a conservation area, and I believe there was lots of misleading information been put forward by some councillors that the conservation area only referred to buildings. It doesn't, it refers to the whole area, including buildings and land.
Yeah.
So that was wrong. We then, after realising possibly that we'd done wrong, we then put a planning application in, retrospectively, which never mentioned we'd put a planning application.